One simple way I try and explain about how we're all mad is this. If you live in Britain, have you ever had a fear of a spider? Are you afraid of those tiny little British spiders that run across your bed or across your dressing table? Are you afraid of them? And have you ever killed one of those spiders because you were so afraid of it? The answer for many of you will be yes. And if you haven't got a spider, you've got the equivalent of a spider, of a dark or a colour or a taste or something. It's something you're afraid of. Now, killing that spider is completely irrational. There is no risk to your life from that spider if you're in Britain. In Australia, I would just kill everything that walked around because most things over there are deadly. But here, small tiny spiders generally, by killing it, you're no more safe now than you were 30 seconds ago. So your response to that situation was completely irrational to a fear that is also completely irrational. Well, that's the source of pretty much all mental health. You take a fear, and of course, for it to become serious mental health, normally it will be a fear that's very much rooted in your mind as something incredibly scary to be avoided. So the root of mental health is fear. You're afraid of a spider. It's irrational to be afraid of a spider because it's not going to kill you. And it's irrational to kill it because you're no safer 20 seconds after killing it than you were 20 seconds before you killed it. That's completely mad. So welcome to being mad. And don't worry, everybody else is too. But if you take that fear and make your response slightly more irrational to a fear that's slightly more irrational, the further and further away you get from rational responses to a fear, the closer you get to mental health being poor or mental illness developing. That's oversimplified, but that really is how mental health works. The other way that that can work is if you have a completely rational fear of a completely rational situation and your response is rational, but people that you trust teach you that your response isn't rational. That's the other way that we cook up mental health. But at the root of it all is a fear, and the fear is normally a deep set fear. The fear of letting people down, the fear of not being good enough, it is for me. It will be something different for you, but somewhere in there is your fear. And your fear is the key to understanding mental health, because we all have it.